caught, you better have the paper.
You better have the truth.
Because if you hit me, I'll help the Lord. But I want to tell you what, to overcome an old judge. Prayer and overcome an old judge. He'll say, have you got this kind of paper? He'll say, have you got that kind of paper? But do you know what he'll do? Let me tell you what he'll do. He'll say, I know that woman. They're praying people. There are people trying to train up people in the way they should go. And I'm going to make an exception. You know what God's done for some of us? He's made an exception. Oh, he's going to try to deliver. And he's sending that order. And it's called the Bible. And he says, we're going to win. We're not going under. We're going up. And we're going out. Big conduit of water. Yeah. And Brother Winslow Hill was sitting by beside. All them people starving and thirsting and could look over the wall.
Yeah.
And Jesus came. Died and left it that way. But his son said, I'm not going to leave it there. He built a wall out on that.
Oh, come on.
You know why? Yeah. Because one day a man was going to be born blind.
Yeah.
Emmanuel was going to spit on the ground.
Yeah.
I don't like them people popping in their hands and knocking me down. I don't like them people shoving me down.
Think about it.
I want to tell you what. The Son of God looked at that man and said his prayer transcends him.
That's right.
And he's here. He was born right.
Yeah.
He come to see him to bring it home.
Yeah.
He was born without sight.
Yeah.
And his mama, listen, brother Nolan, my great grandpa, he was like that. And my grandpa was like that. And I'm like that. Ezekiel says the Lord will not visit the sin of the father on the son. Neither will he visit the sin of the son on the father. Thank you. kind of getting to be sinners.
All right, yeah.
And they put them all in there together. I went walking by and this fellow said, "Hey, preacher, I didn't make you do it, Brother Jesse." But I answered to that.
Yeah.
I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Was you talking with that man in that room? Did you pray with him?" I said, "Yeah, there might be 15 folks in that book." He said, "Would you let me talk to you and pray for me?"
There you go.
I looked back, and the supervisor was dead there. Went like this. And I walked up to that bar door, and I said, "Stick your hand through the bar." And he stuck his hand. I just craved enough to grab it. I grabbed his hand, and he said, "Whoa." I said, "I won't tell you something. You're going to get out of this deal."
Green ball.
I said, "But you are out a long time and not going to get over what you're about to feel." He said, "What are you talking about, preacher?" I said, "You did the wrong thing. You got thrown in jail. And you behind these bars, and now you've asked the Holy Ghost saturated healed preacher to grab hold of your hand."
Yeah.
I said, "I can't control it.
Yeah.
It's already running all over you."
Yeah.
He looked at me and said, "What is it?" I said, "It's the Spirit of God."
Yeah.
I said, "Sometimes he'll open doors of jails."
Yeah.
But I said, "Most of the time, he goes right straight down into your heart."
Yeah.
And I said, "All of a sudden, that old breaking spirit that you had last night won't be there when you walk out."
Yeah.
He said, "What do you do?" I said, "I'm about to close my eyes, and I'm going to pray." And then